In this video, you will learn how to use Google Scholar to find scholarly journal articles that are available on the web. Let's try a Google Scholar search and see what we find. What you're seeing in this list is not a list of web pages, but rather a list of articles that were published in a journal at some point, but have been put into electronic format and are now indexed by Google. Some of them come from university web pages, some come from government websites, and so forth. But there are also some links to articles located elsewhere. For instance, this is an article that is available through a service called Science Direct via a university website. But as you can see here, there is no full text available for this article. There is just an abstract or summary and some citation information. It says here I have to purchase the PDF. And since Kish Library doesn't subscribe to Science Direct, I'm not going to get the full text of the article in this case. However, this article, which is from the National Institutes of Health website, does give us a full text link. So in this case, we will be able to view the whole article. There are a few things to know about Google Scholar. As we've seen, not all articles indexed by Google Scholar have the full text available for you to read. Furthermore, some research topics are covered well by Google Scholar articles, while others are not. For these reasons, the Kish librarian suggests that you not use Google Scholar as your only source for journal articles. Instead, first try a library database source like EBSCOhost, and then use Google Scholar as a supplement to it. If you're not yet familiar with EBSCOhost, you can watch our instructional video to learn how to use it. Here's an example of using EBSCOhost and Google Scholar together. Let's say we do a search in EBSCOhost on that same topic, the Tuskegee syphilis study. We find an article that looks really interesting, but there is no full text link for it. It says not available online, and Kish does not subscribe to a print copy of the journal, so we won't be able to get the full text. However, when I copy the title of this article and paste it into Google, I find a PDF of this article available for free from a government website. Once in a while, you will find an article that is not full text in EBSCOhost, but is available via Google Scholar. So although Google Scholar is not a replacement for a search tool like EBSCOhost, it is an excellent supplement that in many cases helps you find great scholarly articles. If you'd like further help finding scholarly articles with Google Scholar and EBSCOhost, please stop by and see the librarians at the library's reference desk, or give us a call.